मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सो टुडे इट इज द क्लास ऑफ सेल्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट। टिल नाउ वी हैव नॉट कवर एनी केस स्टडीज। सो आफ्टर द कंप्लीशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट यूनिट इट इज माय फर्स्ट केस स्टडी फॉर दिस ईयर। So, students, before I am going to the topic regarding the topic, the main topic of the case study, let us clearly understand. Clearly, you have to have a knowledge about the case study in the social and life science. Case study is very, very important. It is a research methodology involving up close, in depth, as well as detailed examination of a particular case. You know, examination and interpretation and suggestions regarding on a particular case, it may be different from different people. Okay, it little bit difference you can find it. May how they have to, that is they have the clear, that is a view on that topic, but little bit difference will be fine, because analysis of a case is different from the different person. Way of analyzing it is different from different, but that is a person. So whatever may be, I will some points before going to that of the case study. And you know, case study is a to record the process into the development of the particular person. Development of a particular person, the groups or the situations over a longer period of time. You need to examine, you need to find it. What is that case? How you have to handle that case? How to find the solution of the case? So, my dear students, before I am going to topic, so how to interpret the case study? So, first of all, what happened? I am telling that is, first you have to read and examine the case thoroughly. Possible solutions or changes needed, and select the best solution, then dropping the case. So students, when you are going to the detail, when you are regarding have a case in our end, so the first point, read thoroughly what the case reveals you, what the case is trying to make you understand, what the case is pointing to you, that you have to find it. And you have to examine about the case thoroughly by taking notes and highlight the relevant fact, and we have to underline the key problems also. That is the main work we can get, that is the work done in first point, that is the reading and examining the case thoroughly. Second, we have to focus our analysis. At least 2 to 5 points we have to find analysis, we have to 2 to 5 points we have to find it. You have to require to find that is 2 to 5 points or the problems which are related to the key problems associated to the case studies. And also we can say, why do they exist? How do they impact? Means that the case study, the problems which are arised, that is, they may have an impact to that of the organization. And who will responsible for these problems arises, what we have analysis it. Then, third point, we have to uncover the possible solution, the changes to it. From the analysis, after that we have to bring out, we have to uncover, we have to find the solutions, the most probable solutions, okay, or any changes we require, whatever may be, you have to given it, that is, you have to present it, okay. And you have to review the very courses of readings also, and you have to discuss, and outside the research, and our own experiences also included in that thing, okay. Then, after that, you have to select the best solutions here, whichever the best solution, what we have to provide. Out of the solutions what we have, we have to select it, which one is the best solution to our case study, that we have to find it. Okay? Because if we consider the strong support, evidence must be there. Without evidence we cannot prove that in our case, what we have solved, it is a good to us, or it is appropriate, the right. And we have to talk with the, that is, we have to find the pros and cons of the case studies, and we have to question out, that is, whether the solution is very realistic or not, that we have to also think about it. And while we are drafting the case, we have to keep these things highlighted, that is what happened. Introduction to the case. Introduction is also very important. That is another background. Okay, when you are drafting, it is the background is also essential. Then evaluation of the case. Okay, evaluation of the case, and that is proposed solution, or the changes required, and recommendation. Another, that is finalizing the case. These are the very very important things you have to take it, okay, while you have to draft the case. When you are going to the drafting the case, it is your, that is final steps, the finalization. After the finalization, what happened? That is, it is one of the things very, that is, while you have to present ourselves regarding the case, we have to take the points, okay? So
So this is the what about the case study.
Students, now today I will discuss one of the very important cases. Okay, let us go to the today's case study.
PepsiCo Distribution and Logistics, that is a operation which leads to success. You know, the PepsiCo is a US based world leading beverage and snack food companies. The PepsiCo is what? That is, it's a world US based company and that is leading beverage and snack foods. Okay, and its headquarters is also at New York. And this company has a largest revenue, mostly 28% that is with revenue. Okay, and consisting of that is American dollar 25.11 billion, and growth rate is 6.8%. Okay, and you know PepsiCo, it is a serve a diverse market mostly with 6 groups. What are the groups? The diversity about that is mostly that is Frito-Lay, North American, and फ्रिटो ले इंटरनेशनल अनदर पेप्सी कोला नॉर्थ अमेरिकन पेप्सी बीवरेज इंटरनेशनल एंड ट्रॉपिकाना एंड अनदर कोका फूड. सो पेप्सिको इट इज मोस्टली हैज ए वाइड diverse market, creating a strong position in the market by providing all the associate groups. One of the very group good companies that is who had associated with the PepsiCo, that is the Frito-Lay, okay, another is named as a Frito-Lay in North America as well as also Frito-Lay in international, and another that is PepsiCo. Pepsi is also collaborated with the cola that is also in the North America, and PepsiCo Beverage International is also another company which is part that is associated to that of the PepsiCo, and Tropicana and the Coca Foods. These are the water brand mostly it is that is very important segment about the PepsiCo where he is mane got born. Jahan pe mane started kiya wahan pe born hua na ye बहुत नाम दैट इज आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट ऑल द थिंग्स ओके अबाउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द कंपनी. सो जनरली पेप्सिको स्टार्टेड विद ऑल द थिंग्स एसोसिएटेड विद द कंपनीज इन 1898 आई टेल यू अबाउट इन 1898 started by whom? That is Seller Brandham. Seller Brandham, who invented the PepsiCo, and he started marketing in 1903. Okay, and a developed a bottling franchise, bottling, okay, that is the bottling franchise. Bottling franchise for the drinks. Who? The owner of the, that is PepsiCo, that is Mr. Seller Brandham. But gradually PepsiCo was bankrupt in 1923 mein uska bank unhe bankrupt ho gaya. But in 1931 Lofty Candy Company, that is Lofty Candy Company, brought up and merged to create a Pepsi Cola. Okay, Pepsi Cola bottling company in 1941. It may be happened in the 1941 yahan pe laya. Okay, who product? That is Lofty Candy. Brought up the company, the PepsiCo, which are totally bankrupt in 1923, and in 1965 the company merged with the, that is Frito-Lay. यहाँ पे जो Frito-Lay है हम डिस्कस किए थे, Frito-Lay के साथ उन्होंने इंटरनेशनल ताकि उन्होंने PepsiCo इंक्लूड किया. ओके, नेम्ड एज PepsiCo. ओके, द कंपनी आल्सो diversification into restaurant also, okay, and also in 1900 80s, PepsiCo acquired the franchise to build the strong business in bottling business. Strong in the bottling business, expanded overseas its business toward the whole world in 1990s. And the company that is framed, or there is a Pepsi bottling company in 1998, okay? 1998 was started bottling me. Or in 1989 only, he entered into the Indian market. Because we know that is India is also market of large customer. Jo bhi international company, they are always trying to focus on the China and the India because of the high population, that we know very well. They create that is a large revenue from here, okay? And PepsiCo is also not a weak brand, it is a big brand, okay? And you know, here he named it, that is a with a global vision. PepsiCo came to India in 1989 with a vision of performance with purpose. Like Pepsi, Lay, Kurkure, then your Tropicana 100% Choki, yes, Avi, that is dissolved, bring to the carry to the India. And here in India, PepsiCo is named as PepsiCo India. What it is? It is a PepsiCo India. PepsiCo India. It is named as a PepsiCo India. And the company has also a model partner with over 24,000 farmers. 24,000 farmers, that is what happened. He made a model partnership. Opened the bottling franchise here also, that is what happened. Anywhere, whatever be, but he bring up that is directly associated to that of the what? That is farmers. So that he carry out the raw material and which will be helpful in the low cost, the affordable cost that of the people or the customers better than the other drinks. And he also indirectly employment of almost 2 lakhs people here, who PepsiCo India provides 2 lakhs employees, okay, recruitment in India also. So this is the history of the what happened. That is the PepsiCo and PepsiCo India. So another, let us discuss about, as we are the belonging to the sales and distribution management. So how that is PepsiCo created a sales and distribution in which led to its own success. Okay. This is one of the hottest and most important talk about the industries today. PepsiCo is broadly best, mostly best on the sales and the distribution. That is DSD, that is direct store delivery. One of the very important distinctive factor here, and another BWD, that is broker warehouse distribution and that is B&FS, means that is vending, food, service system. See, these three criteria that is PepsiCo introduced in India or made the success of the sales that is there in the distribution section. Direct store delivery means direct store delivery, matlab store se hi jayega. That is जो भी लार्ज अमाउंट लेंगे, दैट इज यहाँ पे बॉटलिंग होते हैं, दैट इज वॉट एवर मे बी दैट इज द PepsiCo एंड दैट इज दे आर सेंडिंग ऑन द गुड्स डायरेक्ट डिलीवरी टू दैट ऑफ द कस्टमर. ह्यूज लार्ज अमाउंट इज ऑल्सो कैरीड विद द रिटेलर्स, नॉट द सिंगल और 10 or 20 दैट इज अ पीसेस, बिकॉज दे आर कैरिंग विद द लार्ज पैकेट buckets, okay, means they are direct delivery to, that is the, from the store to the store delivery, okay? Not to the, that just like a home delivery to the direct customer, they are also going to, or giving direct to the stores where the this PepsiCo can be sell out. And a broker warehouse distribution is also there. See, here it is direct delivery and there is the broker delivery, okay, brokers. There is also a little some the chain systems, supply chain systems, where it is, they are interlinked, the middleman services, that is the broker facilities, okay. They are also being, these types of what happens, that is the controlling the distribution systems. And another, that is the vending force service systems. आजकल रास्ते के ऊपर जो वेंडिंग जोन होता है, नहीं तो स्ट्रीट फूड होता है, जो भी होता है, वहां पे भी वो लोग डायरेक्ट भी कंपनी के माध्यम से भी देते हैं. They are also directing delivering the goods. In three criteria, they what when they are maintaining the distribution sections. Okay. And mostly the company concentrated in two ways. That is what happened in India. The company what focusing on the bottling and what distribution plant. In India, it is the bottling and distribution plant. And another. That is, it is on the basis of company owned. A company का होगा और दूसरा जो bottling, that is, and the distribution plant with franchise basically. Franchise. Okay, यहाँ पे बरमपुर में हिंदुस्तान जो लिए वहां पे फ्रांचाइज लिए, that is. About the breweries of the PepsiCo, they are also providing the large amount. Okay. Because in order to why these two things, एक तो company के ऊपर company direct they are giving, they are providing. The company owns that is the bottling and distribution company का खुद का है और franchise के हिसाब से भी bottling and distribution भी रखते हैं ताकि easily they can create a market. Okay. And easily they will demand the market, they will fulfill the demand of the market as well as to that of the customer. Okay, agar ye agar franchise mein hoga to bhi ye apne 24 hour service mein bhi mil sakta hai kabhi kabhi. We cannot that is think so that, but gradually that is kabhi bhi hum jaakar bhi us mane स्टॉकेज के पास भी जा सकते हैं, जाकर भी हम ला सकते हैं एट एनी मोमेंट. द कंपनी इज ऑल्सो वॉट एपन हैड ऑल्सो 5 रिटेल चैनल्स लाइक सुपर मार्केट्स, रिटेल मार्केट्स और रिटेल स्टोर्स एंड द फाउंटेन्स एंड द रेस्टोरेंट्स एज वेल एज द कन्वीन्स स्टोर्स एंड द वेंडिंग एंड अदर्स. 5 रिटेल जो चैनल होते हैं वहीं पे भी ये लोग देर सप्लाइंग द goods also. And there were other distribution channels also preparing, that is to the airlines and the hotels. If we say the distribution and logistic part, it is very, the distribution section is very good as compared to the other companies. Because though PepsiCo is fulfilling the choice of the customer at any time, fulfilling, that is the requirement of the consumers at any time, because the what the plant here created on the both the basis of the owner as well as the basis of the what, that is the franchise, these are all benefit to that of the creating market. As well as that is what we have, that is the distribution sections, the DST, PWD and B&FS. These are all what happened, that is strengthening the position of the distribution sections. Okay, and so let us discuss about the some benefits. In 1990, Frito-Lay served more than 4 lakhs, that is retail customer in every week, 1 week, 4 lakh. Okay, that is 4 lakhs retail customers per week. It is an outstanding, you know, that is my friends, these are carried, that is we throughout the more the 10,000 that trucks are routed, but that is to handling, that is 1600 distribution centers, 10,000 trucks, 1600 distribution centers, and weekly 4 lakh retail consumers they are handling in 1990s by Frito-Lay. And what you have, the DST, that is the store, the door, or that is the direct doors delivery, or that is the store door delivery system is also granted the freshness of its product, stock nahi rahega, ultimately it will be the quality and the quantity of the quality of the product will be very good, there is no chances of the old stocks, okay, because they are direct, that is delivering with the everyday basis, okay, and reduces the retail inventory system, jitna bechna hai utna lakar bhi bech sakte hain, स्टॉक करने की जरूरत नहीं है, वेयरहाउस का भी जरूरत नहीं है, एंड ऑल्सो व्हाट हैपेंड, मिनिमाइज द होलसेल एक्सपेंसेस इज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी वन इंपॉर्टेंट 3 पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सेक्शंस, एंड ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड्स दे ऑल्सो कंसंट्रेटेड ऑन द डीटीएस, ओके, डीटीएस मीन्स व्हाट हैपेंड यू नो, डीटीएस, ओके, down the street, okay, रास्ते के ऊपर ये लोग आए बेच कभी कभी देते हैं, जो रोड के ऊपर जो भी सप्लाईज होता है, जो भी कुछ होता है, इसका मतलब है दैट इज जो सॉल्टेड स्नैक्स है, ये सभी सॉल्टेड स्नैक्स, ड्रिंक्स नहीं है, ब्यूरेज नहीं है, सॉल्टेड स्नैक्स जो आता है मोस्टली कवरिंग द रिजल्ट 65% विद द सुपर मार्केट में जो है ना 45% सुपर मार्केट में इसमें से 65% होता है और सुपर मार्केट में इट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द ग्रेट दैट इज बेनिफिट और द प्लस पॉइंट टू दैट ऑफ द PepsiCo. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द लॉजिस्टिक, PepsiCo mostly have 2 phases of the logistic. One is giving syrup to the bottlers. जो यहाँ पे bottling है ना, very important. जो syrup आता है ना, वो directly they will put in the bottling and they will provide to the customer. okay, and there is also distribution of bottles and the cans to the retail outlet, that is also maintained. So the product quality and uniformity standards is also maintained, and along with the timely delivery. Timely delivery is one of the very, very important point. The company is also, what about, extended its logistics system by, that is ECNA. ECNA means, that is PepsiCo North America, PepsiCola. Pepsi Cola North America. North America. Okay? So who mostly objectives the timely delivery and reduces the transportation cost, and it is the world largest PCNA, that is named as a Pensic Logistic, is also associated with the Pensic Logistic, which are providing the largest transport system throughout the world. Okay. So these are the what? The benefits and the logistics system. So what are the problems arises? When you discuss about the problems arises, problems is Frito-Lay, Frito-Lay and beverages, are delivered separately cost of labor, fuel and time incurred and another distribution channels concentrated more on supermarkets and restaurant and no ERP systems. Okay. Students, because अगर डिलीवर अगर सेपरेटली जो हो गया ना, सेपरेटली होने के नाते उनका कॉस्ट ऑफ लेबर भी बढ़ गया, देन इसके बाद देन इज फ्यूल एंड जो कि ओवरहेड चार्जेस वो भी बढ़ गया और टाइम भी बहुत कंज्यूम भी हुआ. ये धीरे धीरे पेप्सी को थोड़ा मुसीबत में डाला. मीन्स इट इज पेप्सी को देयर इज फेस सम प्रॉब्लम्स हियर एंड PepsiCo also distribution to channels thana wo directly focus ke super, that is the restaurant and supermarket ko. So jo retail baki jo hota retailer jo wholesaler the unka bhi, that is they create some problems, and there is no ERP systems in maintaining, that is the records. Okay, and no separate distribution systems of each brand, that is also increases the cost. My dear students, the best recommendation for it, the chill DST system for product, that to be required in order to continue refrigeration, and hybrid systems should be extended, and streamline operations and integrate the system must be there, and also that is integrate the distribution channel of the product with the same destination, and you have to allocate, that is a resource that emerges a market in the India and China, because India and China is the largest what, that is the consumer sector. My dear students, this is the what when the topic about the PepsiCo distribution and logistics operation that lead to the success. Okay, And my dear students, it is particularly students belonging to the group A, mentioning group A, okay. And the questions for this topic is that is, we have to study the case and analysis the strategy of PepsiCo in India by making the SWOT analysis with Mukarthikam, okay, that you know very well, okay, SWOT analysis, okay. Strength, weakness, opportunity and create, because these are the totally internal factor and this is the external factors. Okay, here let us explain. By SWOT analysis mein tum karoge, that is strength, weaknesses and opportunities and threats. This is the both the internal sector, internal factor, okay, and this is the external factors. Okay, my dear students, you analysis the case thoroughly. And also second question, that is what happened, the in what way PepsiCo should maintain the sales and distribution functions in India better. Okay, your problem, you solve the cases, the group A students make a good presentation, and I will put the within 3 to 4 days you have to solve it. And on the next, on the Google Meet, we will go for the presentation of your case study. So I hope the all the students better there is good make good understand from this case study analysis. And anywhere in the doubt, please call me, and so that I can help you. Thanking you. Have a nice day. Stay home. Stay safe.